Hello everyone, iCool Tech here. So it's that time of year again where Apple has just released their annual major iOS release, in this case iOS 15.0, and you're debating whether or not it would be safe to update your iPhone SE first generation to the latest iOS release. So in this video, that's what we're going to be talking about, but before we get into it, I should say that you have an iPhone SE and you care about that iPhone SE, and I cover iPhone SE, which means you would benefit greatly from tapping that subscribe button and enabling post notifications using the bell icon just below. Anyways, let's get into how the iPhone SE handles iOS 15. So starting off with the overall performance of iOS 15.0 on this iPhone, I can say that there has been a slight decrease. Apps tend to load a little bit slower than normal. However, this is a 15.0 release, which means usually things like this are common and will get ironed out with updates like 15.1, 15.2. It happens pretty much every year, so we can look forward to that, but it is something I've observed, so I thought I'd mention it, especially if you're somebody who truly does care about the performance. Even on iOS 15, however, the A9 chip in the iPhone SE first generation still powers through pretty much anything. It is incredible how fast it actually runs, considering its age and the fact that it has 2 GB of RAM too, and we look at RAM management in just a second here, compared to 6 GB and 4 GB of RAM of newer iPhones. It's truly, truly remarkable. So taking a look at animations, I have to say animations since updating iOS 15 have been incredibly smooth. There is no problems that I've experienced at all. Stuttering is pretty much non-existent, which is something that I'm really thrilled to say, especially on a device of this age. I've had no problems. It's been an improvement over iOS 14 without a doubt, and it makes me really happy to see that there is fixes here. So with that said, let's just show off the App Library and Widgets page, considering those were the two biggest, I think, animation problems throughout iOS 14. The App Library did have improvement throughout updates, but it was never really the smoothest interface in the world. However, now in iOS 15, you can see the smoothness is pretty much where it should be. There is very, very, very little stuttering. You will have it occasionally here and there, but other than that, it's perfectly smooth. Now the Widgets page, no improvement through iOS 14, but all of a sudden you update to iOS 15 and it is lag-free. There is no stuttering. I haven't experienced a single stutter in the widgets page since updating. That's awesome. So since updating iOS 15, I'm gonna be completely honest right here that RAM management sucks. Seriously, the worst RAM management I think I've ever seen on the iPhone SE first generation. Again, it is the 15.0 release. Maybe this will get patched in a future update. We will have to wait and see for that one. But as a 15.0, RAM management is horrific. All right, so before I get into battery life on iOS 15, I should just mention that my maximum capacity is currently at 87%. So it's getting to a point where I will need to replace the battery. Also, my iPhone SE has had an unexpected shutdown, but I've disabled performance management in settings, as you can see right here. So now that that's out of the way, let's talk about the incredible battery life. And the battery is actually, right now, I have to say, better than iOS 14 in general. The percent right here you can see is a static 79. It is not going down. If this were iOS 14, this would be dropping as I'm talking on the home screen with, I think, just settings in the background. So it's better. I would say it's definitely better. Standby time is also slightly better. I haven't noticed any major drain. Actually, my iPhone 7 is having a harder time with standby time than this is, and that's saying a lot. So I would give battery an okay here. Not the best, not the worst, however. iOS 15 has actually been really good with overheating on this iPhone. Other than, you know, like iOS 14 or 13, it would just be overheating doing pretty much nothing. But this is impressive. 15.0 seems to be okay with overheating. I'm not going to say it's 100% free of it because it's not, but it's definitely an improvement. Now, I just want to reiterate something very important here. After you update your iPhone's firmware, you will very likely notice overheating, battery drain, and possibly performance decreases because, again, the iPhone does a lot of background processing right after an update, and it could take about 1 to 3 days to overcome that and complete the tasks. So now we've gone through all of the major topics, now we're brought back to the main question of should you update? So there is really no definitive yes or no answer to this. It's more of a few questions that you have to ask yourself. Do I need any of these apps? Do they need to be updated, or to download them, do I need a newer version of iOS? The answer is yes, then maybe it would be in your best interest to update, because while you might be sacrificing, you know, battery life or performance or even RAM management, assuming that you care about that, it might be worth updating just if you truly need that app. Same thing goes with iOS features. If there's a native feature that you could really benefit from, or that you just need that's in a newer release of iOS, then I would also probably recommend updating in that situation. If you are currently perfectly fine where you are right now, you don't need any new features, you don't need any newer iOS releases, you know, for app compatibility or anything, I would probably recommend staying there as long as you can. All right, everyone, that is all I have for today's video. Now, if you do have any questions, or if you found value in this video, you know, whether or not this video helped you decide if you wanted to update to iOS 15 or not, or you'd just like to say hi, make sure to leave a comment down below. Of course, definitely make sure to follow me on Twitter using the link in the description as well. Thank you all for watching, and I will see you in the next one.